Welcome back once again, everyone. My name is Prestige, bringing you another five more things. Yeah, probably, wait a second, we've already done this before. Five more things. That does not sound right either. Let's just cross this out right here and put a number three. This is the third time we've done five things you probably didn't know about Call of Duty Black Ops 3. Remember, if you learned something new from this video or find any of these tips helpful, to click that like button down below. It supports the series and it'll help share it with your friends. But without further ado, let us get started. We all know that you can take the HCXD and ride on walls, but did you guys know that you're able to take the HCXD and ride on top of water? Technically, water will act as flat ground for you, so you're able to just roll right across it with the HCXD, allowing for some really extravagant kill feeds and kills in general. This is a great thing to use in game modes like Domination on the map Hunted, and it's also great for the map Aquarium since there's so many wall running spots and just water everywhere. Coming into that number four spot is a simple one, but it's going to help you earn a lot of XP. When an enemy calls in a Rolling Thunder score streak, you're actually able to take out the Rolling Thunder drones. This allows you to get 150 score per drone taken out, so if you have an LMG or something with a lot of ammunition, you'll be able to earn a lot of score towards your own streaks just by dismantling the enemies, which is a very good tip to have in your inventory. Taking that number three spot, it is possible to fly the dart drone underwater. It's also possible to deploy and use streaks underwater. This is a great tip to have if you are in a high traffic area and simply want to call in a lightning strike or you want to use your streak. The only downside is if you're underwater for too long, you'll end up eventually drowning. I guess the good part about this is if you are in the dart drone, you'll have about 15 seconds before you do need to come back up for air. Falling into that number two spot, we have the game mode Safeguard. Did you guys know that if you plant a Guardian or a Sentry Gun in the path of the robot, you'll end up actually destroying it yourself? The robot won't actually stop his path. It'll just walk right through your streak, which will immediately disable it or dismantle it. That's not a good thing. It's not a great thing. You want to keep your hardened Sentry Guns in a good area, but don't put them in the path of the robot. Finally, coming into that number one spot, and honestly probably the most beneficial tip in this list today, is that if you're using the Spectre Active Camouflage Specialist ability, you'll be able to walk directly through the path of a Guardian. This is kind of a weird thing, and I'm not sure if this is actually a glitch as of right now that needs to be fixed, or if it's something that's just supposed to happen. The active camouflage, of course, makes you completely invisible. However, I don't think that that should make you invincible to a Guardian microwave beam. However, it is kind of strange that you're still able to be seen on a thermal sight while camouflaged, but you're not able to die from a Guardian. This is something that you should try out. It's something weird for sure. Like I said before, I'm not sure if this is a glitch as of right now, but it's a very interesting thing to help you get behind enemy lines, just in case you're playing a game of hardcore kill confirmed or domination, and you need to take out that Guardian in question before it takes out the rest of your team. But that is it for today's video, everybody. If you enjoyed, make sure to click that like button down below, and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace.